Hi, you guys. Welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Kori Ashton here at WebTegrity in San Antonio, Texas. And today we're going to look at putting short code inside of PHP inside of your WordPress dashboard. So what does it look like to try to put a slideshow on your home page if the author hasn't just allowed you to do something like that? What if you want it full width up in your header and really make a beautiful presentation of a slideshow? Or what if you're trying to put some sort of a calendar somewhere and it just won't render correctly on a page? I've got a solution for you of how to get it into your PHP files. However, quick side note, as you know in the past, I've shared with you, if you do anything inside of your PHP files, of course you want to be working on a child theme. So if this is already a little advanced, don't worry about it. I've got a couple of other videos in the description box below that can walk you through the idea of how to set up a child theme very easily. Also, how to go into your PHP files without messing anything up. And I've also got another video in the description box below that'll help you put short codes inside of your widget boxes. So that's not what this is about. We are looking at how to put short code inside of PHP files specifically. So let's get to it. Of course, a short code looks just like this. It's inside of brackets, and it's some sort of function calling for a plugin, more than likely a plugin that you've put into your WordPress website. So how do I get this little nerd code to work inside of a PHP file? Well, you could, if you wanted to, on a theme, try to just go into the page itself and paste the short code. Of course, it works like that. But if you're trying to put something maybe up in your header and the author hasn't given you an easy way to do that, there is a way to get there. And of course, you'd want to be working again on a child theme in order to get to these PHP files. But for the sake of this tutorial, I'm just going to run right in here and jump into my header. Now, remember that a header runs at the whole top part of your website, and it of course repeats on every single page, every single post, if that's the way the author has coded it, which is more than likely. So if you're going to put something in your header, it will repeat on every single page, every single post. So if that is not what you're trying to do and you just want it to be on your home page, you'll want to look for a different PHP file. You'll want to look for one maybe called frontpage.php, or perhaps one called index.php. Again, completely dependent upon your theme. So if this is going to get a little confusing to you and you can't get this tutorial to work, you might want to look at your theme's documentation or go talk to your theme author in their support forum and see if they can help you get this short code where you want it to sit and appear. What I'm going to give you right now, though, is the PHP code that you put that little short code inside of, and it turns it into your awesome slideshow or calendar, whatever it is you're trying to render. All right, so let's say I wanted to put one full width up here in my header. Of course, I'm gonna go back to my header PHP file, that's where I'm at, and I already have my slideshow plugin in place here, the fluid responsive slideshow. This is a free slideshow. If you're looking for something more fancy than just images turning, you might want to look at the rev slider. Of course, we've done a lot of tutorials on that, and I'll put the link to that in the description box below. It's a premium slideshow, so you get a lot of options. So if you're just looking to do a couple of slides rotating back and forth, this is really a pretty great plugin that we found for free. And this, of course, once you've created it, is the short code that you would want to use to embed. But if I go here to my header, and I know this can look a little intimidating to you, but what you want to do is you want to look at an end tag here that says end header. This won't mess anything up as long as you're meticulous right here. And this is another reason why you need to have a backup in place before you're doing this. All right. So be sure you've already clicked backup and you know you have a backup in place. If you want to, you can copy this whole entire PHP file and put it in a text document or something before you start tinkering here, so you know we don't mess up anything, right? Because this could break your whole website. You need to just be cautious as you're going through here. Be very meticulous. So I'm going to show you again, just before the end header tag, I'm going to drop in there and paste in my, let's see here. Oh, back that up for 1 second here. I'm going to go get my short code right here, grab my short code for my slideshow, come in here, and just before my end header, I'm going to put in that little short code. Now, if I click update and jump back over here and click refresh, it's not going to work. And it's very difficult to see because it's black text sitting on a black background. But my text is sitting right here. My short code just sits there. It's not working correctly. That's because short code, kind of by default, does not work on its own inside of a PHP file. You have to put it inside of a PHP call. So here's that information right here. This is a PHP line that tells our browser to render our short code. So here's what we're going to grab. We're going to grab this whole thing, and I'll put this in the description box below so you can just copy and paste it. We're going to come back here. We're going to paste that in. We're going to take our short code that we actually do want to render, and we're going to back out this one that says insert your short code here. So I'm going to delete that and paste it in here. Now, if I'm going too quickly, just press pause for a second. Rewind this and walk through the steps. It's super simple. All we're doing is pasting in a bit of PHP, and we're going to replace a short code in there asking WordPress to render our slideshow. So let me jump out of the way here. I'll click refresh. And now, because we put it up in our header, our slideshow works beautifully, but of course it's going to be on every single page, right? So if I go over to results, it's going to be in our header, and you can zip through all of our different slides. If I go back to the home page, of course it's going to be there. And again, it's going to be on every single page because I put it in my header file. If I only wanted that to work inside of my home page, I can just grab that little bit of PHP and go to my front page now. And what you're looking for is kind of the start of your content on that page. And I'm just going to drop it in there, and you can tinker around and play as long as you have a backup in place of your website and you know how to restore it. You can always tinker around inside here and play. So I've placed this now on my front page. And now if I go into any other page, it won't be there. So that's how you take short code and put it inside of PHP. Again, please be sure to be using a child theme if you're doing something like this, because the second you update your theme, this will disappear completely and you're gonna have to go do this again. But if you're using a child theme, it'll always, this PHP file will always overwrite that parent PHP file. So have fun with this. You can tinker around as long as you want, as long as you have a backup in place and you know how to restore your website. There's all sorts of extra resources for you in the description box below. Have fun. If you have questions, put them in the description or put them in the comments, and we'll do our best to answer any questions that you have. Have a great WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.